Last year was a year of information collection, where we did a lot of audits and a lot of report writing. And this year is the year of action, where we act on some of those reports that have come out. So, forging ahead 2018 and beyond. So like I said, we have received the financial reports, the HR and the systems audits, and this information shall be disseminated into the various teams. We shall come on the ground and we shall inform you of what. This forum is too large and the time is too little for us to start disseminating information here. But we shall come down and talk to you and give you the information as on a need basis. The gaps of these three reports were that we realized that it wasn't addressing some of the softer and non-tangible issues that have been going on. For example, the finance, the HR, the systems audits were addressing the what. The what is wrong, what is right, but they never addressed how, the how, and the why. Why are things the way they are? Because the risk is that you then fix it based on these three reports, and then it is not sustainable. Issues degenerate again. So from that process, we still felt there was a gap in terms of the information we had, and therefore we proceeded to do an audit culture, as well as engage a change agents or change managers or change consultants who began engaging us in the change management process. What we quickly realized from this and what the consultants then advised us is that we are a value-based organization. It means we do what we do because of the why, not because of the what. Many organizations probably do what they do and stop there. But for us, it is more about the why we do what we do, and therefore the culture change process. We need to interrogate ourselves and find and refocus to what we need to start doing better. So the differences between some of the audits were, one of them was the softer issues. And then this second process, the change management process, had 100% of staff involvement. I think if you've not been involved, it was by your own choice. Either there's a form you didn't fill, or you didn't go to the forums that you were invited to, because literally, according to the HR had scheduled all the staff to go to this forum. And all the opinions were given there. So there was an element of upward progression. They first came to the SMT, took our views, and then went to the mid-level managers whose views were taken, and also views of skepticism. From there, they went to the board, because that was one of the issues, the sticky issues about skepticism as to whether this issue had buy-in from the board. The board gave its word, and it gave its blessings for the process to go ahead. They went back to the staff, and I think they've been meeting in Cure with teams through October, November, and December. Like I said, if you didn't go, it was by your own choice. And so the deliberations we reach today are based on a collective idea, a collective opinion. They then went to the mid-level managers, they actually went to the unions also and collected information. They then digested this information and packed it, or this data, and packed it into information and delivered it to the mid-level managers in Naivasha. This was then, in combination with that information that was gotten from the managers, and the data that had been collected from the ground, was then given to the SMT. We have had a 5-day retreat with the board where we've deliberated seriously about these issues. And we all agree that it is time to refocus. It is time for us to look at where we want to go. It is time to reestablish the true north. Some of the things that stood out was that one of the issues is that the staff has evolved over time. The staff has become a sophisticated human being. The staff is now much more qualified, a higher level of independence, liberation, and professional as compared to maybe 50 years ago. And we own the mistake that as an organization, maybe we've not adapted to these changes. This illustrates that even more. You can see the NAS of the 1950 coming to the NAS of 1980, coming to the NAS of 2017. And you can see that even a shoe was a luxury then. So maybe one of the faults, and we apologize for that, is that as an institution, we have not evolved with times to stay adept with the changing demands of the current staff. The other thing is the patient has also changed. You can see this is a waiter here. I don't know if this works. Yes. This is long gone. You wouldn't find such patients. The patient of today is again much more sophisticated. We are saving much more complicated human beings, and this is taking a toll on our staff. It requires higher level of ingenuity, higher level of excellence, higher level of concentration. Even our partners, the missionaries, have evolved. From a time when, in the 50s, when it was come to Africa to save Africa, to now people who are focused to partner with us so that they can build capacity, so that we can save human beings not in additional factors, but in logarithmic factor. So, for a long time, maybe this has been the problem, that we have made the patient happy at the expense of our staff. We are saying, no more. But we also don't want this, where the staff is happy and the patient is crying. What we want is that, a happy staff, but also a happy customer. A happy staff so that they can deliver compassion to the client, because at the end of it, it's about the client. And therefore, after all this information, we decided that our core values will be the following. Values that protect the organization, values that protect the staff, and values that protect the patient. Compassion healthcare protects. Compassion healthcare is for the patient. It is the need, and that is why it is number one, because it is our singular drive. Accountability is to protect the organization. Employee engagement is to protect the staff. But all this has to be sustainable so that everything is protected. So that at the end of it, our intention is a delightful client and staff experience. So it goes back to the why. We do what we do to glorify God. Okay? And we will do what we intend to do. The how we will do it is through the people. So we have to start focusing on people. And therefore, the new dawn. Isaiah 43:19, as read, reads, "Behold, I will do something new. Now it will spring forth. Will you not be aware of it? I will even make a roadway in the wilderness, rivers and the desert." We are heading towards very territories that we've never been. Who said that low-cost care has to come at the expense of the staff. There are many organizations that I can quote to you who offer low-cost care, but they are still able to meet the demands of the staff. So it is possible. So if we go to what we decided, some of the things are financial stewardship. Everything we do must be now costed. And therefore, we agreed with the finance department that in the next 3 months, in the next month, we shall outsource for costing services. And within 3 months, we shall have costed everything we do so that anything, any intervention, anything that goes into giving compassionate healthcare patients is costed so that we run efficient processes. We shall automate, again, as part of the efficient processes. Our aim is in 9 months, actually, let's say by the end of the year, but in 9 months to go paperless. This will also help us in the process of inclusive budgeting. I have had many complaints that, oh, we don't know what happens to the budget. We shall now engage in a process of inclusive budgeting. But inclusive budgeting has two prongs. One, there's the participation of what you want to, how you want to generate and spend. But there's an element of accountability. How did you actually spend it? Or how did you actually generate it? So that we engage and we change from, all the decisions are made up here to a process of distributive responsibility and leadership. We shall engage in a process of regular submission of some financial reports. This is in line of one of the values, which was accountability and transparency. Our plan is in the next 3 years to triple our revenues. Because if we do not generate revenues, we cannot become sustainable. We will not deliver on a delightful customer and staff experience. Quality has been the premise of only one department, but now we are saying quality is being elevated to a strategic agenda so that everyone understands that quality is not about the medical team or the nursing team. It is the total output that results to quality healthcare in a patient. We shall put processes that result in efficiency. Our intention is to drop the waiting time to global standards within 9 months also. We shall streamline admission processes so that we introduce things like express services for elective patients and things like that. Again, our plan is to reduce waiting time for elective surgery to 3 months by end of year. We shall streamline our maintenance processes to enhance responsiveness and accountability. We intend to engage in an energy audit and probably even roll out solar in the next 2 or 3 years so that some of our costs are manageable. There's an oxygen plant, which is a sticky issue. We need it so that we can do more surgery. For the staff or the people, we are going to do remuneration alignment, basically salary adjustments, by end of February for everyone. We are in the process of introducing transport for the staff, and this shall be done by the end of February also. We shall engage. One of the things that culture change brought out is a deficiency, or let me say, to sound politically correct, suboptimal leadership. So we shall engage in a process where we take our leaders through leadership training so that when they come to engage with you, those softer issues are dealt with. We shall also engage in a process of recruiting culture agents so that they can constantly conduct surveillance on the culture change that we intend to roll out. In line with transparency, the audit reports, like I say, are out, and we shall immediately embark on a process of information dissemination. But what needs to happen? One, there has to be a radical shift in ideology. We have to stop thinking silo and think cross-cutting, because at the end of it, we are all here. Healthcare to God's glory, and it is through compassionate healthcare. We have to stop thinking small, and we have to dream big. Who said that Kijabe has to stay in Kijabe? Who said Naivasha has to remain a medical center? Who said that Marina has to stay what it is? Who even said that we only have to run these three or four centers that we have? We have to think about spreading our tentacles. We have to disrupt the market. In the process of enculturation, accountability. Let me add, mutual accountability. It shall be what I say is what I do, and what I do is what I say. So, for me, as the CEO, I promise to deliver a safe environment for you to work in. But on the other hand, it can't be that we give all that and you're also not accountable to your actions. If you say that you report at 8, you report at 8. If you say work ends at 5, it ends at 5. Yes. So it is mutual. Clap until we come to the action. We shall promote integrity, open communication. We know that one of the things that we have failed at is open communication. But we, as a leadership, all the directors have promised to adhere to this, that we shall open, you know, communication. Employee engagement, we have talked about this. We shall involve in every process. We shall engage in those kampunjis and all forums so that we can better the patient experience and your experience. Like I said, leadership and governance, we shall invest in this process, because it is necessary. It has become necessary. So for a moment, think about where Kijabe has come. One day somebody dreamt, and he came on some ox. And that guy probably didn't think about this. This was a vision for him. This is what he dreamt. And then this guy dreamt of that, and he delivered. And then this guy dreamt of that, and he delivered. And when these people were bidding, they were thinking about that. So who said we have to stay there? Yeah? We have to open our minds. We have to think big. So that it has to be a collective ideology. We have to all refocus on the one direction. Stop the petty politics and focus on what we want to deliver. And I put these people here as examples of people, of companies who have disrupted the market. When Safaricom came into the market, a mobile phone was 300,000 shillings. A scratch card was 10,000 shillings. Do you think they lowered the cost at the expense of the staff? So it is compatible. Low-cost care is compatible with staff engagement and fulfillment. Equity Bank. We know Mwangi disrupted the market. He is now offering banking services, quality banking services, for the farmers, the peasants, and the people down there. Understand? Microsoft did the same thing. Machines used to be big in rooms like this, and it only belonged to a certain group of people. But Michael, that guy, whoever, Bill Gates, dreamt that one day this thing shall be a household item. And he delivered. Do you think staff were less engaged because of that? Do you think the salaries were less because of that? No. So these things are compatible. And there are others. There's well bishop, there's Loma Linda. I put actually these two here. So that those of you who think, how can he mention non-Christian organizations? It is because Christianity has no room for mediocrity.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes.
You can professionalism, when you become a Christian, who says you become less of a professional? You start showing work at night. Okay? We have to aspire to be the best because we have said we are a leader in healthcare in sub-Saharan Africa. This is where leaders are. Equity Bank is a leader of banking in sub-Saharan Africa. Safaricom is a leader of communication telcos in sub-Saharan Africa. Do you think they are only based in Nairobi? No. Okay? So we need to start thinking big. Our intention, our focus should be invading the space in Kenya. There is a space. Many people are providing quality care, but very expensive. We know them, we'll not mention them. Many people are providing very low-cost care, but without quality. Kijabe is offering quality at cost, or quality that is affordable. We can disrupt the market. We can make people ask questions of themselves. But we need to have a linear focus. I have done my part. The board is in line with this agenda. The leadership is in line with this agenda. I want to believe the mid-level managers are in line with this. Now, we have to focus on delivery. Thank you.